Okay, new Star Trek Online trailer, let's go. Very dramatic. Oh. Okay, that's very familiar. Is that the premonition?
You could say
that's the premonition. Holy crap, that's gorgeous. Wow.
New struggles. We can always rely on old.
There's the Enterprise F. Very reminiscent of Star Trek Armada, not just because of the premonition. No freaking way. That's the Gemini. Holy crap. God, this is just the intro sequence to Star Trek Armada. That's awesome. And Dominion Wars. Man, references galore. That is awesome. There's the Achilles. Oh man.
We will meet these challenges.
Wow.
As we always have. With determination.
There's the the dorsal mounted torpedo. That looks amazing. Wow. Oh, and we got a bunch of Herc. And there it is. the old brick. Oh, that is cool though. So yeah, we've got all three ships officially
because
confirmed now, apparently.
Who would seek to conquer.
What's it gonna do?
Or control.
Cool animations.
Or assimilate.
Oh. What? What?
We have proven.
The heck was that?
And over again. Resistance. Is never futile.
Wow.
You will become one.
What?
The Borg.
Heritage Starship Bundle. Good name. Okay, some things to look at more closely. First off, we got our first real look at the Premonition, which seems to be more in the 2409 style than the, you know, more 2370 whatever style that you would kind of would have expected from Star Trek Armada. But this is gorgeous. I mean, you guys know I'm already a huge fan of this design style that Star Trek Online uses. That is just fantastic. I love this. I really like this bit with the deflector down here too. That's neat. Though the big standout is in its console, or at least that's what I'm assuming that's what this is, because, I know what that is. That is the Gemini effect from Star Trek Armada, which was originally an ability from the Nebula class, but this is what it does. It splits a ship into two ships and turns it, and yeah, then it just kind of disappears. Oh, that is so cool. I mean, this is something that I had been hoping to see come when we got the monitor, but I guess we're getting it with the Premonition, which seems appropriate too. I mean, the Premonition was, you know, a huge part of Star Trek Armada, and while it didn't have that ability, it makes sense for Star Trek Online to introduce it with, you know, the ship from Armada. Oh, that looked so cool. I'm really curious to see how that ends up, you know, practically working in the game. And then, of course, there's the Achilles, which definitely looks more like in its the mid-2370s like you would expect with the Dominion War. So this one doesn't seem to be going off into a different design language. This is more authentic to the original, and ooh, it is pretty. I really love that they kept the phase cannons on the forward section of the saucer. That great little detail, very unique to this ship, and just absolutely looks fantastic. And sadly, it doesn't look like we're getting the Hutet. Clearly, this is just the Damar, substituting in for the Hutet. So it looks like we're not getting that quite just yet. But look at the Achilles; it is just out here doing its thing. And here we
As
go.
We always have.
And there they are, the dorsal-mounted quantum torpedoes, just kicking the crap out of it. That looks so cool. And then there's the Typhon showing up, which, I mean, I've expressed my feelings on this ship already, but, I mean, look what they did with it. Stowe really did a fantastic job here. This one also kind of fitting in better with its design style that you would expect from the game it was from. Yeah, the gold deltas are very much indicative of the mid-2370s, though the hull material doesn't look quite like... it's a bit lighter than I would have expected. I was expecting something more dark gray, something like the Akira's hull, or even like the Sovereign's. I'm not sure what hull material this is, but it looks good on this ship. And, you know, I say that as being already not being a huge fan of the Typhon, but I am very interested on what it's doing. That is interesting. The animation of it kind of like huddling up. I imagine this is the fortress mode that it had in Star Trek Invasion. Which, side note, I never played Invasion, so I don't really know what that's supposed to be, but this is intense. And then, of course, we get this cool shot of all four ships, you know, Enterprise plus the three new ships all going off doing their thing. And then we get this big reveal of a fusion cube. Now, a fusion cube, that is not something I expected to ever see make it into Stowe. I had always hoped, but holy crap, that is awesome. I've said in the past, obviously this isn't going to be a playable ship, but I've always wanted to fight one of these monsters, and this is going to be fun. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed this reaction and a bit of a breakdown of the new trailer for the Heritage Bundle. Actually, let's put this on the screen. But yeah, the Heritage Bundle. I'm hyped. I have rarely been this hyped for a ship bundle in like a long while. Like, this is I'm excited for this. This is gonna be cool. I'm just babbling now. That's how excited I am. I don't have words. I just have just sounds, and they're all just, you know, emphatic screaming of excitement. So yeah. That's the Heritage Bundle, guys. I haven't seen stats yet, but that'll be in an upcoming video soon. Let me know what you think down below of this reveal. Like, comment, subscribe, do all the usual outro stuff. Anyway, my name's Stu, and I will see you guys next time.